Hello, and welcome to the latest edition of KDAB News, the usually monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and in this two-month summer special, we have the following topics for you. CppCon organizer John Kalb gives us an update on his plans regarding CppCon this year. A new online event for the Qt for the Desktop community called Qt Desktop Days. Then we have a sneak preview of how Qt3D is getting ready for Qt6. And of course, our announcements and resources. As you all know, organizing conferences has become pretty difficult lately. Trade shows like CES in Las Vegas have decided to go completely virtual, and so has CppCon. We had the pleasure of asking John Kalb a couple of questions to know more about the inner workings behind planning such an event.
Well, there's an expectation about what the conference is year after year, and we want to preserve that. And there's a lot of things we just can't do. A lot of things require being able to see people, but we want the value of being able to talk to really intelligent people who are solving the kinds of problems you're solving and meeting the challenges that you're meeting. And that's what we want to preserve. And we have to figure out how do we make that possible in an online world. And we've found some ways of doing it. The conference won't be exactly the same, but we are meeting the challenge of preserving what people expect of CppCon and of our brand and still giving them value and preserving that. That's what the challenge has been, and that's what we think we're going to be able to do. And I'm very excited about that. Well, the biggest upside is that there are an awful lot of people who we know would love to come to CppCon but can't. They either can't do that kind of travel or they can't be away from families or work obligations for an entire week at a time. And so they're never going to be able to go to CppCon. And they would love to be part of it. And this is the year that they can do that. This is what's really, really exciting. You know, there are people who are craving this because they're not even seeing their coworkers. If you want to have a real discussion about code with an intelligent person who's trying to solve what you're trying to solve and maybe has some different ideas because they're doing a different approach, there's a real hunger for that out there. And this year is an opportunity for everyone to participate in that, not just people who are able to travel and be able to get away for a week. And, you know, when you talk about classes, the kinds of instructors that we are able to present in our classes, your company can hire them and bring them in, but that only makes sense if your company has a dozen C++ programmers or 20 or two dozen or something like that. If you're in a smaller company and there's only five C++ programmers, you never are going to be able to afford to bring in these kinds of instructors. So you have to go to a conference. If you can't travel, then you can't do that either. This year is a unique opportunity for anyone anywhere in the world to be able to get first class instruction online at CppCon. And so that part of it is, it's really disappointing for me that we are not able to do the regular event that we want to do, but this is an opportunity for people that we've never been able to offer before. And that part of it's really exciting.
That's great. Thank you very much, John. Unlike the usual conference format, Qt Desktop Days will be a series of talks on different days. Check out the agenda linked below to learn more about the topics and speakers. The call for papers is still open until the 20th of August, so if you'd like to submit an interesting talk, we're looking forward to your proposal. While the start of Qt6 is coming closer, Qt3D is moving along right behind it. Up until now, Qt3D was relying on OpenGL for rendering. With the upcoming Qt6 update, it will come with a rendering abstraction layer, Rendering Hardware Interface, or RHI, to target not only OpenGL, but also Vulkan, Metal, and DirectX. This will allow it to leverage the same convenient Qt3D APIs while using the best rendering backend available for each platform. It also means we now have a solution for the OpenGL deprecation on Apple platforms. The capture shown is a glimpse of Quasar and Q3D using Vulkan for rendering through the Qt's RHI abstraction. There are still missing parts, but Q3D will be ready for the Qt6 release. Last chance to sign up for a one-day introduction to CMake on the 25th of August. You will learn in a small group with one of KDAB's experienced trainers. The course teaches you the basics of creating and building projects with CMake. Qt Company announced that the Qt12 Summit will happen fully virtually on the same dates in October as the original event. The agenda still has to be announced. Finally, Meeting C++, usually taking place in Berlin in November, announced their agenda, and you can now sign up for an online-only ticket. If you would like to attend the conference on-site in Berlin, you can sign up to a waiting list. Containerization is not a real word. Oh, it is. Containerization is starting to appear in embedded, but it is definitely not yet commonplace. This new white paper provides a general overview of containers embedded from our own knowledge, research, and experience, including Terizon from our partner, Toradex. Thanks for watching. Stay safe and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. See you next time.